you in the 50s walking with me by the shore. I didn't think they made chords like these anymore. Eugene didn't reply, but he was more of a listener than a talker. Actually, they both sometimes felt talking was awkward, which was odd for a psychoanalyst, but maybe not for an illustrator slash author. And no one suspected they had wildness in their hearts, but they would go dancing where the wild things are. While Eugene was preoccupied worrying about TV, its constant availability, it's a desperate necessity, but Marie said, Eugene, that's exactly what you are for me. It was a joke though, Marie's preferred books to television, which was good, cause books were how he made his living. Books for kids, although he famously claimed that he didn't write for children. And they would sit on the rooftop under all of those stars, just saying nothing where the wild things are. Away faster than April snow. They both got older. Eugene got sick first though. Maurice took his hand and said, please don't go. After that, every second dragged by like months, until at last the monsters came for one final stunt. He stared into their yellow eyes, didn't blink once. There will always be monsters and little boys and little girls, but now there's a hole in the world where the wild things were. Love is a fearless an unkillable beast, and Maurice loved Eugene, and Eugene loved Maurice.